Laura Place hopes to get a good night's sleep tonight. She lives right off Highway 311 in High Point.
Just late at night, cars driving fast up and down the road.
Sports cars seized in an undercover street racing sting.
At night, probably, I mean, anywhere from like 9 o'clock until like 3 or 4 in the morning.
And it's continuous or what?
Yeah, I mean, mostly on the weekend.
But this weekend, the drivers
16 to 23 age range
are behind bars and their tricked out cars are confiscated. This after officers went undercover.
This probably went on almost 2 months now.
And befriended the leaders behind this dangerous growing problem in the Triad.
I mean, why in High Point? Is this a trouble spot?
This is a trouble spot for us.
It'd be nice to, you know, for them to stop so we could sleep at night, but, you know, I guess it's kind of hard to stop everybody.
And with this undercover sting, they hope to do just that.
Racing is always dangerous. You are taxing the driver. And again, these are young drivers, so they haven't been driving in a long time. We're talking about drivers that don't have a tremendous amount of driving experience to begin with, much less taxing a vehicle 60, 70, 80 miles an hour in a 35, 45-mile zone.
Back live, you can see that officers are still basically checking the first of what they expect to be 20 cars seized in the street racing bus. As I mentioned, police say this is very dangerous, and they're most definitely trying to curb and stop this serious and dangerous situation here in the Triad. Reporting live in High Point tonight, Ben, back to you.
And Jermont, besides their cars, could they potentially lose their driving privileges as well?
Yeah, they can, Ben. According to North Carolina law, if you are caught in street competition, you could potentially lose your license for up to 3 years. Now, the people, as you heard in that package, police say that many of the people are teenagers, and they're being processed as they're getting off of Highway 311. Basically, they're catching up with them, taking them down to the magistrate's office, booking them. Now, these people can face anywhere from misdemeanor charges to some felonies as well. So this is going to be a very long sting and undercover operation that will go well into the night. We'll most definitely have much more coming up on the morning news. Ben, back to you.
And Jermont, what are police doing right now?
Well, as you take a look behind me, as I mentioned, this is the first car that they brought in. But right now, they are basically looking for anything illegal. I talked to Sergeant Pete Waddell with the Highway Patrol. They say that, you know, sometimes people have marijuana, other drug paraphernalia inside the car. As you can see, they are actively taking pictures. Basically, they want to document how this car came in. So therefore, when they use it as evidence, they can then have what they need to basically prosecute these people who are drag racing throughout the Triad. Ben?
All right, Jermont Terry reporting live tonight from High Point. Thank you very much.